put this person in a leadership position. How the hell did he manage to become a manager? He himself needs some serious lessons in management and leadership. Dear guests, fellow Toastmasters, and my evaluator, and the A1 director, a very, very warm welcome to what is a very, very passionate subject to me. Anybody can lead, but not everybody can be a leader. Okay? Anybody can lead, but not everybody can be a leader. That's because leadership is not at all about a position. It's not at all about a designation. It is about the qualities that you display and whether you are able to create the results that you need to as a result. How many of you here agree with me when I said that? Can I have a raise of hands? Thank you, dear audience. So today, I'm just here to share one perspective of leadership as to what those qualities of a great leader are. Well, it comes straight from the horse's mouth of one of the most popular leaders in the entire world, Jack Welch, who's been at the helm of an organization, GE, for more than 3 decades of his life. He says, or rather, he has this principle of 4 E's and a P. 4 E's and a P. He says that the qualities of any great leader is, number one, it's all about the energy that the leader carries. Do I like to be around my leader? Is the energy positive or is it negative? Is it empowering or is it disempowering? So the first one is the energy that a leader carries. The second E that is there is the ability to energize. Otherwise, there's no fun if you are an enthu cutlet as a leader, but then you don't have the ability to drive people to function with the same energy, because anybody solo cannot produce a lot of results. You need the effort of the team. So that is the second E. Now the third E is, what is the kind of execution capacity you have? Okay, what is the kind of execution capacity? Which means, are you talking about castles in air? Are you just doing the PowerPoint presentation and Excel demonstration? Or do you have the ability to really get onto the ground and make things happen? So what is your execution capability? Not just that, there's one more E that Jack Welch talks about, which is having an edge, which is about taking the risk that a leader needs to take to make things happen. Can I fire somebody for their non-performance? Can I take some tough calls which are necessary for the business? Whatever is the edge that I need as a leader, do I have that edge? Although these 4 E's are things that Jack Welch talks about, he says the picture is incomplete without this one element which drives practically the whole world, passion. Then does the leader have the passion to go ahead and create those breakthrough results? Now, why did I pick up this topic about how anybody can lead but not everybody can be a leader is because recently the Kerala floods and the way the fishermen operated in the whole scenario taught all of us a very critical lesson in leadership. They did not have any designation. We would not know about them on a regular day. We wouldn't dream of thinking about them on a regular day. But did they display the 4 E's and the P? So firstly, did they have the positive energy? Of course, they had the positive energy where just because the Navy ships, which were much bigger, the Navy boats couldn't get into the waters, they took their canoes and literally physical and mental energy, ferried people back to safety. Energized. Did they manage to energize others to do the same? Within no time, they mobilized their entire community of fishermen and ensured that whoever was in trouble in the entire state, they got them back to safety. Edge. Did they take the risk of their own life? Did they take the risk of reaching out to people, getting the money, getting the resources from anybody? Because while governments and organizations were splurging money into corporate social responsibility, it is these people who actually went ahead and displayed the passion and demonstrated the power of execution in the true sense of the word. So, how many of you now feel that leadership is way beyond an authority? Leadership is way beyond a position. Leadership is way beyond just having a fancy designation or having that corner office with a MacBook or with a private jet or with a foreign trip or with just strategic envisioning. I think what all of us need to understand about leadership, and even Jack Welch says that in his book and he has practiced that in his organization, that it's not about the other things. It's about whether I as an individual, at an individual level, demonstrate these 4 E's and the P. Because Without these four E's and the P, it doesn't matter how good I am as an individual contributor, I can only walk so much. I will never be able to build nations. I will never be able to build communities. I will never be able to build anything that is worthwhile. So my dear fellow Toastmasters, since Toastmasters is also about leadership, what kind of a leader do you want to be? Because anybody can be, but not everybody can be a leader. Thank you.